Eddie. Not joking. From Edie to Eddie in Erie.
One more D.
PA on 92.1 FM. Hello, Eddie in Erie. Go ahead.
Hi, Patrick. Yeah, how are you?
Good.
I'm sad to hear that you're leaving.
Thank you, sir. I appreciate
you're
that.
You're my most favorite speaker.
Wow, that's high praise. Mm-hmm. Thank you.
A child would know that abortion is wrong. So as we've gotten older, they've just twisted our logic and tried to convince us it's right, mm-hmm. you know? So I'm definitely pro-life, like the three of us, and most people, anybody actually before, you know, they get polluted by the world. But
right. So what's the question, Eddie?
Argument, if somebody says, you know, well, I you know, they rape or because of this or because of that. Do you think murder is, you know, is that right, you know? And if they say no, then you say, well, it's murder. So you'll be accountable for that.
Mm-hmm. Eddie, I have to ask, what's the question for Trent? Are you saying, should we use the word murder or, pardon me?
No, it's just, why would someone not be pro-life?
You know?
Oh. Well, that's a good question. Trent.
Eddie brings up a really interesting point, actually, because mm-hmm. when I've done pro-life fair booths, at the Arizona State Fair, I used to do this to volunteer. Many other pro-life organizations do this. They'll have displays of fetal models out for people to look at. And when children under the age of 7 come up, they're just in wonder and awe of these models of babies. And they love these babies. They say, oh, look at the baby, look at the baby. They always say it's a baby. And I would say that they're naturally pro-life. They don't know what abortion is, but they know these are babies and that you ought not hurt these babies. And that's just what it means to be pro-life. So you wonder, how does someone go from that natural stance to the view that these children are not valuable? How does someone make that conceptual leap? I think a few reasons. One, if we're just talking purely argument and worldview, as children grow older and if they are indoctrinated with a modernist way of thinking, they will think that belonging to a certain type is not what makes you valuable, but what makes you valuable is what you can do. Can you speak? Can you think? Can you write? Can you jump? Can you run? What you do is what you are, not what you are controls what you do. And so then as they get older in junior high and high school years, they'll look at this unborn baby they saw as a 5-year-old and say, because it can't think or feel or survive like them, it's not as valuable as them, so they're not a person. That would be one, I think the argument might change for people. They value function over identity. The other, I would say, is that children have no problem protecting the right to life of the unborn, because the lives of unborn children do not impede their desires and wishes. But adults who would like to have, for example, sexual relationships without consequences, suddenly the life of an unborn child can impede their desires, and thus the rationalization for abortion is born, mm-hmm. not to make a pun.
Yes.
So I think those may be the reasons why someone would abandon the natural pro-life view they would hold as a child and embrace the unnatural view that not all human life is equally valuable.
Yes, good metaphor. Nicely conceived, to coin another metaphor. Eddie, thanks for the kind words. I appreciate it. Another thing I appreciate about Eddie's point is that most children are there's a default appreciation. A baby's a baby, a person's a person, no matter
yes.
how small.
That's right.
The idea of a 7-year-old saying, you know, I believe the mommy should have a right, because we can be awfully annoying at times and inconvenient as kids.
But it's because children yeah. understand. Children recoil at abortion. Because mm-hmm. especially, let's take a 4-year-old.
Yeah.
To know that a mommy would end the life of her baby because she doesn't want them anymore, and you're a 4-year-old, you can't fathom that. What if mommy doesn't want me? What would I do? You're a 4-year-old. You're powerless. You identify with these babies. They're powerless too, in that if your mother or father wanted to get rid of you, maybe if mm-hmm. you were 9 or 10, you could fight back, but as a 4-year-old.
Yeah.
Wouldn't stand a chance, really,
yeah.
that children see the beauty of life and the inhumanity of violently exploiting human life.
Eddie, thanks for the call.